What's up, weirdo? Sage Resurgeon here on the Rocket 3. Heading over to Jason and Jess's house to meet them up, to go out to the shame, to meet Baldy, a guy I haven't seen in quite some time, a really good friend of mine. And it's so funny, I've met up with Baldy 613 literally all over America. We've hung out in Las Vegas, we've hung out in California, we've hung out in Florida, and he just recently stopped being a cop. You know, he stopped being a cop and he's a truck driver now. Anyway, he's in town, and since he's hanging out, we're hanging out. He's taking his first vacation since he started driving a truck, and I'm eager to hear how he likes it compared to being a cop. It's got a, I don't know. I mean, slightly less dangerous? Given how people drive on the roads, I don't know how much less dangerous it is.
So over here at Jason and Jess's house to show you guys what a garage should look like. You guys are used to seeing my mess, but every time I come over, and I think I have mine cleaned up sometimes, but then every time I come over here and look at how organized Jason's garage is, I just feel ashamed of myself. Our original plan today was to go try out some Harley Davidsons for Jess, but I guess it rained us out. We didn't get to go do that, but the Suzuki Savage 650 is actually looking pretty dope these days. Jason did a little overhaul on it. I think it is looking mighty fine. That tank is super freaking cool. That's not actually painted, that's bare metal. I don't know if that shows up. Sometimes I don't know if on video you'd be able to tell if it's bare metal or not. It looks kind of like silver paint almost because it's so shiny.
Yeah, it kind of does, but
yeah, it looks great though. It's freaking cool.
We tried silver paint and it just looks like shit.
No, that looks awesome.
So WD-40.
Oh yeah, if you guys have any suggestions for Jessica for motorcycles, leave them down in the comments. Something that can do highway speeds and someone who's 5 foot tall can ride without a problem. You let us know. Yeah. Apparently that magical motorcycle does not exist.
Help me find my unicorn.
It's true. So for comparison's sake, do you mind?
No.
Okay, for comparison's sake, because everyone's like, oh, get her a Bonneville, get her this, get her that. So that's a stock Bonneville over there. That is a stock Bonneville just sitting there. Now look at Jessica's legs on a stock. On a stock Bonneville. Don't get off you. I'm gonna go around the other side.
But you have to see the arm.
And the arm reach. Okay.
The
so there's the feet. And there's the reach. So again, leave your suggestions for a motorcycle that can do highway speeds that Jess can fit on just fine, because it's harder to find than you might think. But we'll be test riding some stuff here pretty soon.
Well, here's a new sight. Motorcycle's actually in front of me. Y'all are always bitching that I'm always in the front of the pack, and it looks like I'm not riding with anybody, so here you go. But Jason and Jess are riding in front of me this time. We got Jason, Life a Winner on the Scrambler, Jesse Gray on Instagram on the Suzuki Savage 650, and Jess isn't with us. She's going to be bringing Zuko up to the bar, so she's taking the truck. Jess is going to hate me saying this, but she looks so tiny on that bike that it looks like Jason's got his like 13-year-old son out riding with him. I'm sorry, Jess. And also, that isn't really fair. I know a lot of 13-year-old boys who are much bigger than Jessica is. You know, I think we're actually going to get to see Bobber Fett up at the bar, too. We got a whole Shade Tree reunion going on right now, you know? Although Bobber Fett was in a video last week. Yeah, I don't get to see him as much as I used to because he travels for a living now. Didn't used to, but yeah, he's on the road quite a bit. And that's always a bummer, but we try to hang and ride when he gets back into town. And of course, the fact that Baldy's here is getting everybody together. And that's one of the things I love about YouTube the most, is it makes the world a smaller place. It ends up connecting you with all these people from around the world that you otherwise would never know. And I think that that is pretty fucking cool. Why would I ever be friends with a cop from Cincinnati, Ohio? But I am. And now he's in Tampa, Florida, and he's gonna hang out at the Dirty Shame, and we're gonna drink some beers together, like, all through the power of the internet and motorcycles. Pretty cool, if you ask me. We have three very different sounding motorcycles right now. A single, a twin, and a triple. And it is creating a cacophony of engine noises. But it's a symphony that I can get behind, baby. I actually had another guy come up to the bar last night, Ben. He was shooting some pool with Baldy, having a good time. And Shazam. I can't remember his name was Sam, but he said he goes by Shazam. He came up to the bar too. You know, I always get people asking whether they're allowed to come up to the bar. And the answer is yes. You are allowed to come up to the bar, but there are three simple rules that you have to follow. One, you gotta be 21 years old. Sorry to all the people who might want to come and hang out who are under 21, but all we do is sell alcohol. If you're not of age to drink alcohol, I can't have you in the bar. That's all there is to it. Rule number two, don't be an asshole. If you come up to the bar and you're an asshole, guess what? You're gonna get asked to leave, and it's not gonna be in a very polite way. And rule number three, don't piss off Richard. If you haven't seen all my videos, you might not know who Richard is, but Richard is the guy with the big mustache and the long hair. And if you annoy him, your time at the Dirty Shame is going to be very brutal and very short. Now, if you can follow those three rules, hell man, come on up to the Dirty Shame and have a good time. Why not? You know, people say, am I worried about dudes coming up to the bar? I'm like, no, random people come up to the bar every day. That's kind of the whole point of a bar, isn't it? That you open the door and random people come in? I don't know. What's really kind of funny is I had this guy talking shit on Instagram, which just, I don't quite understand it. It's when people use the word triggered in the wrong context. You know, John Maxwell, the Harley tech, had very, very nicely shared the fact that I'm trying to get to 100,000 subscribers, and somebody commented on there and said, you know, I hate Josh and his shitty girlfriend, Jessica. I went up to the Dirty Shame and they were super rude to me, and my wife wanted a picture and they basically told her to fuck off and they were super drunk. And I went, hold the fucking phone. That never happened. Anybody who's ever come up to the bar, I've gone out of my way to be polite to and say hello to. And if somebody wants a picture, you know, it feels kind of weird that somebody would want a picture with me. But if you want it, you got it, bud. And yes, a lot of times when someone comes up to the bar, I am at work. Guess what? I have a job to do. That doesn't mean I can't always just hang out and have a super long conversation with people. But I mean, it's a bar. There's people to hang out with. There's pool tables. There's beer. You'll find ways to amuse yourself. But I've certainly never one goddamn time been rude or blown off a fan or anybody else for that matter, unless they really had it coming. So I saw that shit and I called that dude out and I said, you're a goddamn liar. That never happened. I don't believe you. Tell me what day it was. Tell me what time of day it was. Tell me where it was at. You're full of shit. And guess what? I was a little pissed because I don't know about y'all, but I don't like people spreading lies about me. And then his first response after that, he goes, oh man, why are you so triggered? Why are you so triggered? I was just joking. That ain't a joke, Bubba. That's a bald-faced lie of you talking shit and saying stuff about me that ain't true. Oh, what do you expect me to do? Just go, ha ha? Hell no, dude. I don't know what to think about that. Am I triggered when somebody says something nasty about me that's not true? Yeah, I am. And hell, you can't please everybody. There's a ton of people on the internet that can't stand me. They just hate my guts. Which, again, like I've said a million times before, is really funny to me because how can you hate me? You don't even know me, dude. Like, you've seen like 5 minutes of one of my videos and you've decided that you hate my guts and you hope I die of super AIDS. I don't know, man, if 5 minutes of one video of my life is enough time for you to make up your mind that you hate my guts and want me to die. More power to you, bud, but I'd say you probably got a little too much time on your hands. Get a hobby. Anyway, see you guys at the Shame.
I got so many bugs in my helmet.
That's what they make a visor for, you know?
My visor was down. They smelled underneath.
And by the way, if you didn't know, that's Richard. All right, since Rob isn't a cop anymore. Sorry, Baldy 613. Since Baldy 613 isn't a cop anymore, now he can answer all those burning questions you always wanted to know and get real answers for. So we're going to hit him with some rapid fire questions here. First off, what made you want to be a policeman officer?
I was in it for the money.
Have you ever been shot?
Yeah. Never shot.
Have you ever been stabbed?
Yes.
Is it true that there's a place in a man's head, if you shoot it, it'll blow up?
If you have the right gun.
Have you ever fired your gun up in the air and gone, arg?
Yeah.
Have you ever jumped through the air whilst firing two guns and shouting, ah?
No, just one.
Devin and John John are here. You might remember John John from Jessica's Wreck video, which has actually been getting some action lately. But Devin's 30 years old now, and if you remember his 29th birthday on the YouTube channel, there was a whole mess of cheeseburgers here. He's saying no, but his face and his gut says yes. Whenever anybody comes to Ybor, they always freak out about the chickens, which I guess is fair. People are weirded out that there's chickens everywhere.
I mean, the first time I saw one, I took it.
Yeah. Yeah, we've owned a couple of Ybor chickens. I guess it's unfair. You can't like be like, oh, the chickens are everywhere. Shut up about the chickens. Like, it is kind of weird to just see random chickens everywhere. Also, file this under things you only see in Ybor. Impromptu photo shoot in the alley next to the trash cans behind the Dirty Shame.
Do you know how often I see people like doing photo shoots on the train tracks?
Oh God, all the time, dude. It's so artistic. Yeah. All right, so me and Jason were just sitting here like having, not an argument, but a debate over what's a better movie, Ernest Goes to Camp or Ernest Scared Stupid. And so what we thought was, do you know who Ernest P. Worrell is?
At all?
Do you, Angelina, do you know who Ernest P. Worrell is? Jason, you're old, dude. Hey. Don't say piss.
Oh, it's my channel?
It's your channel.
Pee-pee.
This is what the dogs look like when we come home to greet them. That's what a shitty kitty looks like. Harvey, look at Harvey's tail.
Whoa, Harvey. Wow.
I'm still in my helmet, by the way.
Grab your glass.
Go on, let them beasts out.
Are you ready? Ready for this?
Okay.
Whoa!
Oh my God!
Take me down.
Oh my Lord.
Nobody else is allowed to be excited.
Oh, Grim, chill out. Grim, we've been gone for like 2 hours.
Yes.
Grim. Oh, my
Grim,
Lord.
Oh, God. Wow, your dogs are so trained. Wow. Oh, movie magic, people.
He almost fought Gunner. I saw his hair.
Hey, don't call him out.